अगेन लॉट ऑफ पीपल हैव यू नो सम क्वेश्चन इन माइंड, यार ये सैंपल का साइज कैसे डिटरमिन करना है, ये क्या स्टैटिस्टिकली डिटरमिन करना जरूरी है? नो, लाइक यू नो सेलेक्टिव मेथड और दी देयर आर अदर मेथड्स अवेलेबल वेर यू कैन सिंपली ब्रिंग कैलकुलेट अ क्लास इंटरवल्स एंड अकॉर्डिंगली यू कैन परफॉर्म नॉन स्टैटिस्टिकल सैंपलिंग. ओके, सो वी हैव डिस्कस दिस. Some of the firms have also standardized the size of sample. They have certain, you know, parameters of having a, you know, in a certain risk level of basis. They would say if the risk level is this, if the the sample size would be this. So they have a standard procedures. So when we'll be probably solving at the end, okay, an exercise, you will get a better idea. The last exercise is the, you know, sum up of whatever we have discussed. Now the lower of the assurance required, the smaller the required sample size. This tolerable error, which is, we also call it performance materiality because it relates to each assertion, is also called the deviation rate. It is the maximum rate that can be accepted to conclude that the audit objective has been achieved. So this is in respect of control procedures. For substantive test, precision may be expressed as a monetary amount which is less than overall materiality, for example a percentage of population. Now, whenever there is, we expect a larger error in the population, we need to have a larger sample size. Now, in determining an appropriate sample size, our main concern is reducing sample risk to an acceptably low level. The level of sampling risk that auditor is willing to accept will have an inverse relationship with the sample size. If you look at ISA 530, whatever, you will find appendix 2 and appendix 3. 2 deals with test of control and appendix 3 for test of details. It discusses various factors which influences the size of the sample. Okay, when the inherent risk is high, what do you do? Different levels have been described. It's quite easy. I mean, there's nothing to discuss in it. Selecting and testing sample. Look, every unit should have a chance of selection. It should have a chance of selection. So we should select items for sample for sample in such a way that each sampling in the unit has a chance of selection. What are the different methods available? Commonly used method. These are the methods recognized by ISA. That is why we will be primarily deliberating on these methods also. As I said, a lot of methods available, but we would not get into that, those methods. Okay. Statistical or random selection. First is random selection, systematic, interval selection. Okay, this also method has been discussed. Now, systematic interval selection we have modified into monetary unit sampling, MUS, in which we consider higher value. We select our sample in such a manner that mostly high values are selected in that method. That is called monetary unit sampling. This is also known as value weighted and is used in conjunction with, as I said, systematic sampling. Can you bring that those tables? Not here, from there. Non-statistical are haphazard and block selection. Random number selection. Now here in a statistical method, as I said, that in case of random number table, each and every unit must have the same statistical probability. When we say same statistical probability of being selected, that means every item has an equal chance of being selected. Here, what is important? They should have an equal chance. Irrespective of their value, their characteristics, you should select those items. If you have created a population, you blindly select the items. Now, random numbers are normally selected using the computer program or random number tables. So you will be in due course very soon they are distributing you the handout and also random number tables. This is a random number table that is being distributed to you to have an understanding. But these random numbers you can also generate in your Excel sheet. Is equal RAND, bracket open, it will create a random number. Then you specify an area, it will create further it will further generate, then value them so that every time you enter the figure should not change. So these random numbers will be available. Now what do we do with these random numbers? We correspond it with our sampling units. As I said, for example, if we are testing invoices, purchase invoice or sales invoice or whatever data, what do? We correspond, we create some basis. Now the random table that you have, in this random table, we have corresponded it with, you know, invoices number 0001 to 4000. We have 4000 invoices, for example. So, and we have created a random number. Okay. Now, this random numbers are of how many digits? They are of 5 digits. So, what we have decided, if we will, whether through computer or manually, we will select first 4 digits which corresponds with our invoice numbers. Right? This is what we do in a random number table. Now we pick a starting point, whether by making a blind step or arbitrary. Point of start to aapko chahiye na ek. So if you look at your random number tables, column 1, row 6, this is a random start. No reason for that. Random means bas start kar diya, yahan se shuru karna hai. Agar aapko pasand nahi, aap upar se shuru kar. Theek hai? Kahin aur se shuru kar dein. Last se shuru kar dein. Aur phir aur badha dein numbers. So it's up to you. So you see, when we start at first 92870. Now 9287 is not our invoice number. It will reject. It will automatically go further. Okay. Okay. Next, number 7. I think you can go from top to bottom, left to right. Kisi bhi tarah se aap isko define kar sakte. Your computers will do it, or you can exercise your own judgment and do it. Bias isme isliye nahi hoga ke aapko pata nahi hai ke kaun sa invoice aap select kar rahe. So you are not biased, but problem wohi hai ke it will select whatever invoice comes into its range. Then next is 34862 is our invoice number. Yes, we will select it. Similarly, the third one, the fourth one, the fifth one, and jo site pe jo numbers diye hue were the serial number 1 2 3 4 5, jo initially jo starting numbers. Okay. Or थर्ड फोर्थ सेकेंड रो का हम रिजेक्ट कर देगा, क्योंकि ये 8692 इज नॉट अवर इनवॉइस नंबर, क्योंकि हमारे इनवॉइस